Welcome to Sochi, Russia, host of the World Mixed Double Curling Championships of 2015. Of course, also the host of last year's Olympic, and we are in the same arena, the Ice Cube. You see it right there. And tonight's matchup is in between Russia and Denmark. I'm Sarah Carlson, and I'm joined by the also knowledgeable Sander Rølvåg.
Why, thank you. We're going to have a look at the standings before we get started here. A lot of teams in the mixed doubles competition, three groups, A, B, and C, and there's 10 teams per group. Denmark, Russia, USA, Japan, and Switzerland mix out the first half of our Group A, while we have Slovakia, Turkey, Australia, Czech Republic, and France at the bottom five at the moment, but still early in the week. For Russia, at the female spot, we have Victoria Moiseva, and the male player is Pyotr Dron. Team coach, Sergei Belanov.
And on the Danish team is siblings, Denise DuPont and Oliver DuPont. Their coach is Ulrik Dam. So both of these teams with two wins and no losses so far. Here you see the rules of mixed doubles curling. Of course, doubles, there's two players, one male, one female. Six stones per team, and one of them is pre-placed, so you play only five. You have 22 minutes of thinking time. We play eight ends, and the players will throw either stone one and five or stones two, three, and four. Those, they are allowed to switch positions between ends. Both players allowed to sweep. And it's normally very aggressive curling because there's no takeouts until the fourth stone of each end. And that goes even for your own stones. So only draws allowed. We did have a draw shot challenge before the game. Both teams had practice, and it was Russia that outdrew Denmark. So they will have the advantage of hammer in the first end. You see they also play the red stone, so Denmark will play the yellow. And Denise DuPont is just settling into the hack, getting ready to throw the first freeze. You see the setup right there. The team with hammer will always start with a stone just back of the button, and the other team will start with a center guard. So the first shot is always to come around and freeze. What are the tolerances for this shot, Sander?
Well, there's a few. You can maybe tap the red a little bit, but even maybe stopping a fit short is not too bad. Surely what you don't want to do is slide past the red stone or leave another guard.
So you need to be somewhere close. And,
pretty much.
Denise and Oliver are up to sweep this.
Denise, one of the most experienced players in the field, playing with her sister, Madeleine DuPont. She's played two Olympics and nine World Women's Championships. Played 101 games at the World Women's. Very impressive record. So, played a lot of curling up through the years. And Victoria Moiseva here also playing a lot of curling. It's usually the alternate for Anna Sidorova's team. She was the alternate for the Olympics in the Sveri Arena 1 year ago.
And her teammate coming up to sweep there, he was also here. So quite the experienced Russian team as well.
Yeah, Pyotr Dron, of course, playing lead for Team Russia. Doesn't quite come off that shot from Moiseva, and Oliver DuPont here, playing with Rasmus Sterne this year. He'll have a chance to play the intern draw. And get two yellows in the pin behind the guard early on. This one starting to lose a bit of the handle. And some of the weight, but doesn't end up in a too bad of a spot. Kind of clogging up things, and you'll see Moiseva call appeal on the guards here to open things up early on.
Yeah, this is the first stone you're allowed to hit. And I quite like this. You don't have that many stones in mixed doubles, so if you're in trouble, clean it up fast. Piotr drawn with his first here. And a great shot to get started for the Russian, would you call it middle player, if you call two, if you throw two, three, and four?
Whatever you want, Sarah. Right. I'm on board.
Okay.
Peter John, maybe most known as a lead, but he has played both at the second and third position for Russia, although it being close to 10 years ago. Playing the European B competitions.
I was impressed when I heard how this Russian team have prepared for the championship. They had the qualification, but then the qualifying team still had to play a couple of teams that the Federation had picked out. They won that too, and then they sent a team for practice camp in Holland with another mixed doubles team that was just there to give them practice games. So they've definitely prepared for this championship in their home country.
So, wow, there we go, run back. Picks off both the yellows.
Yeah, there's a crowd in here and we're making a lot of noise.
Not two typical lead shots from Drawn, but two very well executed upweight shots. Still a few guards in play though for Oliver.
Yeah, there are still guards and they are kind of staggered, so if Oliver can wrap one around here, they will still be sitting really good. This one has some curling to do, but we've seen big finish at the end.
Oliver, of course, a World Junior Curling Champion with Rasmus Tjerni, Vancouver 2009, but sort of dropped out of that team for a few years, but now back with Tjerni this season. And did play the European Championships in November, had a really tough competition, only winning one game and being relegated into the B group. Looking to win a few more games here this week.
Yeah, they're already off to a pretty good start. The top two teams in each group will qualify for quarterfinals, and then the best, the third with the best draw shot challenge will qualify as well, and then the other two thirds will play for it. So it can be really important to be top two. And two upweight shots and then a really nice hack waiter from Drawn, and couldn't really make it a lot better.
That's these super shots by Peter Drawn. Mega Drawn, as he's nicknamed. Quite possibly the biggest curling player in the world. Very tall.
Very strong. It's good for sweeping, good lead. Get a lot of power.
Unless he breaks the broom.
Think he'd need a reinforced broom.
Well, I've only ever seen one player break a broom, and that was actually Erica Brown, sweeping behind the tee line. Can you imagine that?
No, I didn't see that one coming, preparing to Drawn. So, Denise DuPont, because Drawn got so close to the guard, there's no real gap here, so she can only, she can't really hit and roll, and this one's hanging way wide. She's not gonna touch it. And there is a split available for Victoria, if she wants. Go for three.
Yeah, I think it's worth the risk. Not very far off the ring, so just a little rub would do it.
Yeah, just as always, make sure that you have good weight so that if you're by, you don't go through the house, you score two instead.
Yep, I think even just with T-line weight here, you can make the split. But as you said, can throw back 12 if you want to. Just make sure you stick around. Even if you pass the reds, you're going to crash onto your shot stone here. So
yeah, of course.
Some weight will be taken off it. So a bit of margin here for Victoria Moiseva. And then that almost looked like a force. Now a chance for three.
Yeah. Cleaning it up early certainly paid off.
Not sure if she has enough weight on that shot, though.
No, it's...
Is it enough to even get two? No.
No.
Wow.
So that was maybe erroring on the wrong side, would you say?
Yeah, I would say so. But, you know, first end, taking tighter ice, playing a whole different path. You catch some fresh pebble and tends to be a bit slower, although players should know that and try and adjust. But of course, very hard. Well, off the hook there, Denmark. Only one for Russia.
No, you don't lose my year.
So with the score of one in the first end, it is Russia to start the second. And Victoria Moiseva now the one that needs to make this very important freeze. Will over curl, so good call to leave it a bit shorter where it's still more usable.
Yeah, 14-15 for him.
Okay.
Just hearing Oliver saying he had 14.15 for a hog-hog split. So pretty quick coming down here on the out turn. Nice information for Denise. Just keeping a track of the speed on the ice. Of course, it changes during the course of the game and the science can be different. There's less sweeping with mixed doubles too, so tends to be a bit more tracky.
So really happy with the line here. And that is a nice freeze. Still though, with hammer coming all the way down, it means that the scoring area is going to be really tight. So if Piotr Drone can freeze this again, it's going to be quite difficult for Denmark.
Another great shot by Peter Drawn.
Yeah, he's... Well, we've only seen him an end and a half, but he seems to be on fire.
Hack weight called by the Danes. All hit and flop of the wide red, I believe. Again, just you know, tightening up the ice. You hit the fresh pebble, there's a bit more bite. And you tend to get a bit more curl. So not quite being able to make up for it.
No, but it will open up the center line. And Russia's going to make a play on it, but Denmark should be able to move some granite after that.
Stay хорошо, чуть сюда тоже.
Мы что решаем?
А? Да, сильный.
I think they're going to play a lot of weight here, and I'm not sure if they're thinking about trying to get rid of both yellows, but an option could just to play the hack weight here and sit right on top of the nose. You're sitting two reds frozen on the shot stone, just remove the back one.
Yeah, leave the 5-second peel to Denmark instead, but this is not short of pace, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, it's pretty firm weight, and I think it just might wiggle things around a little too much. I didn't quite like that call. Yeah, could have played that with a bit less weight.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, just to leave them everything staggered and not widespread around for Denmark to try and create separation.
Really nice shot by Oliver Dupont.
Yeah, that is a beauty. Will definitely force Russia to make another double.
Yes.
Yeah, not sure if the double is on though. Not sure if you can see enough of the yellow.
Oh no, I couldn't see that guard, you're right.
So it seems like they're just going to play a shot on the stone on the forefoot, maybe try and roll somewhere.
Whoa.
See John's whole technique there, the tiny little electrical teapot lift.
A teapot for sure.
Do you remember any other curling players with the same technique?
There are a few. Who are you thinking about specifically?
Well, you got Kevin Cooey. He does that little, tiny teapot lift, even for draws.
That might be a role model for John.
Also, Dave Nidewin used to do that. Not many, though. Fairly unique.
Yes, and while we're talking about teapots, Oliver Dupont has a shot to sit 3. That would really put some pressure on Victoria Moiseva for her last stone. I've seen her throw some really big weight, but she will be facing 3 if he makes this.
Almost over curling, but that rolls to a pretty nice spot, actually.
Yeah.
No easy double right here. So Moiseva just calling a hit and roll right away.
Called to sweep this right away. Oh. She really needs to get a roll if she doesn't want to leave an open hit for 3. And I don't think it's going to be enough.
Yeah, no, even with that weight and that amount of rotation that Moiseva puts on the rock, there's always a little bit of finish from the hog line and end on takeouts. And Drawn not quite anticipating it.
No, because he was calling her off. And Denise Dupont just needs a nose hit and stick around somewhere.
Well, the last takeout she attempted went flying by. So she's going to need to adjust a little bit. playing the out turn this time.
And no guards to worry about this time either, so.
Oh, I think. Bad button, yep. Yep.
Nice.
Whoa, whoa, right. Whoa, 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 whoa.
She's played second and third pretty much all her career, so a open takeout shouldn't be a problem, and it's not. Nose hit sticks around. It's a score of 3 for Denmark.
Okay, we start it. Turn off out hand again.
Out hand again. Yeah.
Yeah, it was a good setup. It was just the question of what weight to play on when Dron hit everything in the forefoot so hard and just spread it wide.
Yeah, I think they might want to go back and have a look at that situation again. Definitely the shot to change it up. And big news on at least one of the sheets here, but can't you maybe update us on all the games out in the Ice Cube, Sarah?
I can. The big news is that Switzerland scored 6 points on Australia, of course. 6 is the highest you can score in mixed doubles, so hats off to them. Czech Republic got 2 points against France in the first end. USA got 1 against Turkey. And Japan has a 3-0 lead over Slovakia after 2 ends.
6 points, eh?
It's impressive. However, we saw Spain give up 5 in the first end in our previous game, and they ended up winning, so nothing's over until it's over.
So what you're saying is it's going to be an extra end over there.
Perhaps.
Since it's 6.
Yes.
Spain winning by 1 point. In our previous draw. On the live coverage. Really exciting game. This one between Denmark and Russia. Only a 2-point difference at the moment. And you'll see Russia really looking to open up the scoring area, punching that yellow one to the back of the 12, so you might see a bit more open play. We have done that so far in the game.
Yeah, it's been quite different from the other mixed doubles games, but I think it's a smart way of playing for the team that has hammer. Try and spread some stones around, keep it wide open.
Just going to mention that Australia scored a 2 back on Switzerland, so trailing by 4 after 2 ends. That's Oliver's draw coming down here. Trying to stay on the back red, but will slide off a little bit. The question is, with all the stones in behind the tee, you might want to bring one in front of the tee line, maybe ignore the O.
Yeah, in front of the tee is normally where you want to be if you're looking to score.
This is a very cautious approach by the Team Russia. They're gonna peel the guard. Well, I think they're trying to roll to the side, leave it as a corner, but
yeah, but again, this is coming with huge weight.
Yeah, a lot of rotation too, just gonna spin off. No, I think they're relatively happy with the result there. But you know, a little bit defensive.
Ну, да, я понимаю, просто да, они очень неудачно.
I happened to catch just a little bit of the final they played to qualify here on a Russian stream. It was played here in the Ice Cube. And there was a lot more stones in play in that game.
Yeah, so maybe that's because they said that going to that training camp with the other Russian team, that was taking care of some little tactical things that they had been working on during the qualifications, so that might have been one of them. So Oliver Dupont is not happy that he didn't get to.
I think what Moiseo has planned to peel off the corner guard was just realizing all the stones are in behind the tee. So they have a good chance of freezing onto things and still leaving the forfeit open to score one. So a little cautious, but you know, there are still chances to score multiple points here. Although saying that, it looks like they're playing a hit. So they're going to try and hit to light two again. Just a little bit defensive, maybe. Could have played a freeze here. Well, sits for two, I think.
Yeah, and that red might catch on the yellow if they try and play the double.
You might see Oliver just throw a rocket down here, see if he can try to spin it off the top. We'll see. Definitely some big weight coming down here.
He's just standing watching this. There's no point trying to sweep it.
Yeah, that was jamming all
day.
Yeah,
it really was. All that speed and for nothing.
Well. Team Russia definitely employing a different type of tactic than the other teams we've seen so far in the broadcast. And now John asked to play the double and sit two. Remember, of course, that if you were to blank an end here, you would not retain the hammer. So you really want to go for a score. And of course, when you're already having to score, you might as well score more than one. And that's a nice double by Piotr Dron. And the question is, can Denise Dupont play this flat double?
I think she has the upweight ability necessary. Just hit this where you're supposed to. You can both go.
Silver medalist at the 07 World Women's Championship in Japan. And you'll see she had pretty good line for it.
Yeah.
Really needed a lot of weight to.
Yeah, it was very flat.
Make it. Lost to Canada, Kelly Scott in the final back in 07.
And this time, again, a wide open hit for the score. Second end in a row, Victoria Moiseva.
Well, let's stick around, though, for Victoria. Oliver trying everything he's got to sweep it out, but no, it's going to cling on. And two for Russia to tie it up at three each. Very different mixed doubles end, indeed. So, even with so few stones in play, it was a very interesting end. Just because it was different.
Yeah, I do quite like to see this type of play. Especially when you have two teams that are tactically good that they are very aware of all the choices they make and they choose to keep it more open, have their rocks spread out a little bit when they have hammer, and it makes sense.
Yeah, I think it's easy to be mentally committed to an aggressive game in mixed doubles. It's hard to see beyond the aggressive shots. We did question some of the calls in previous draws where we might have liked the peel on the guard. But seems like Team Russia certainly has those type of shots in mind.
Yeah, they do, and also splitting stones around a little bit when you have the last stone as well. It's definitely setting you up for that score of two. And this one may be a fraction heavy.
Well, we saw Irantu Garcia do this two times earlier. And what's going to happen then, Sarah?
Well, you're not allowed to hit anything out of the rings. So Denmark is just going to replace this. And now Oliver is asking for the freeze. My preferred shot here is a top 8 foot. Keep the scoring area a bit bigger. If you're all the way down and Piotr Dron freezes it back, it's going to be quite hard to score two. I think if you leave this a bit shorter, you're going to look good for a multiple score straight away.
Yeah, I'd rather leave this 1 foot short of your shot rock than tap it. And, well, she's pretty much frozen onto it, so.
She made the shot called. But we're going to see here, if he freezes this, it's not really going to benefit Denmark that much. It's more likely to become a pocket in the back 4 foot for Russia.
Yeah, no, I agree. Maybe just nibble the 4 foot top eight there would maybe have been better for Denmark.
This is when you need that really strong sweeper. And all the way down there. Great job by Dron.
Yeah, just a marvelous shot there. He's made some really great ones so far. Now Oliver Dupont is going to do the same. Attempt the same.
Now lead now.
Okay, go.
Beat Brett Gallant in the World Junior Final in 09. Brett Gallant, of course, playing with Brad Yushu, the 06 Olympic champion. And that's a really nice draw. Maybe just came up half a foot deep, kind of slid off a little bit there, overswept it a tiny bit, but it's not a bad spot.
Желательно в лоб прям, чтобы довалил.
Да, вот так.
Колодка, может?
Колодкой мы через три не выбьем.
This is a much more typical mixed double setup. Everything in the forefoot, but it looks like Russia is going for the hit once more. You see there. Coach there, Sergei Belanov, on the right.
Well, I think this time they are trying to play the softer weight and try and sit on top.
Sweep! Sweep!
I've seen this happen a few times. You tighten up the ice, try and play the soft weight takeout inside the draw, the 4 foot draw line, and takes off on you. So no guard in play, really?
Yeah.
Four stones in the forfeit.
Yeah. 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 Yeah
Og så ryk måske bare lige, så det får det spredt lidt.
Det kan jeg godt lide. Bare nede i 9, nej 10.
Ja.
Yeah, so I think they're going to try and...
Yeah, stadig herovre.
Kind of slashed your own a little bit.
Er det ikke samme is? Ja.
And maybe try and just wiggle all the stones around a little bit, get some separation.
Yeah, I do like that. Spread them around. Give yourself a chance of a multiple score.
Although taking a lot of ice though, so I think they are just maybe playing a freeze. Another setup shot. We got two more stones after this.
Oh. Okay,
I'm not sure if they're still looking for a little tap to wiggle things around here, but it's not going to be a lot of movement.
Nope.
All those stones are sort of welded together in the forefoot. But it does kind of...
Shakes the red one out of there, but question is... How many are Russia going to be able to remove?
Well, I think at least three.
Yes. Unless it catches, but I don't think so.
I think Nozet here, two ones on the one foot, they'll fly. The top one might jam onto the one on the winger, but then
with
that
enough weight, then
that would fly.
That one's going. Yeah, well, then again, Denmark can hit the open one and sit two, try and split the rings.
See how much weight Megadron can throw down the center line. The 2014 Olympic lead player.
Whoa.
Well, it does exactly that. Gets rid of the three. Just like we talked about, and Denmark will play the hit to set two.
Lots of rotation and lots of speed. He's going to be able to get a lot of stones moving at once. So here we are again. Just a regular end of curling. Need to keep the shooter in a good place here. Nose hitting the angle for the double will be quite steep. But you don't want to roll in.
Sort of grouping the yellows here now though. So that's going to be a double for Victoria Moiseva. Obviously unhappy with the result there, Oliver.
So shouldn't be too complicated, but still need to make both of them go. Victoria can also throw some big weight, but that's not a happy face.
And maybe overthrowing this one a little bit. We'll see. He's going to stuff it. Well,
Denmark might need to move this one if they want to score two.
Yeah, they are calling a hack weight to nudge it over. So, in the end, a decent plan B for Moiseva. I'd say it's not an easy shot here to come down the center line. You haven't played too many rocks down here. Without two sweepers. A very precise shot to be made by Denise.
Don't need to move the red one very far, you just need to touch it.
Whoa.
Whoa. It's away there.
10. Okay. Whoa, whoa. 10. Yep. Yep. Yep.
And it's really, yep, really yep. curling on this side. Yep. She's going to need to give it all no. she's yep. got.
Pause it.
And it's not going to be enough for two. Denmark's going to score one. I wonder if they played that with a little bit too much weight. Pushed it really far, but I guess anyway, you have to make it. Still a good shot for one. And when we head into the halftime break, it's going to be Denmark with a 1 point lead, 4-3. We will be back just before the second half with some highlights. Two undefeated teams playing each other here in Sochi, Russia. And it's Victoria Moiseva that had a possible split for three in the first end. She came up a bit short and Russia scored one. In the second end, stones are spread wide across the rings and Denise DuPont just had a nose hit for three and a 3-1 lead. In the third end, situation was looking pretty much the same, but this time it's Moiseva with a nose hit for two. Oliver Dupont really tries to get it all the way out, but not enough. Russia will tie the game after three ends. And just before the halftime break, it was Denise Dupont that had an opportunity to score two. She will catch a bit too much of the red one and pick up one, but they will leave the game 4-3 after half. And we are now back with the second half of the game, and it is Denise Dupont to get us started with the first freeze. And this looks like an absolute perfect shot. Really nice by Denise Dupont. Almost no separation in between them whatsoever. And, Victoria Moiseva carefully cleaning her stone before following this one down. And I think we'd like to see her maybe tap these apart just a little bit. And I think that will also be the plan. Get rid of the red backing. Get some separation, get some space. Russia is looking for a multiple score. Yeah, when you have a hammer, it's not that bad to wreck on the guard if you get them far apart enough that you have some corners. But of course, Denmark have, and Oliver Dupont, they have a chance to close things off here a bit. So over curling, probably showing the wrong side of this yellow.
And a wobble from Drone. Coming out the hack.
Now get the stones spread apart, but there is a double available, and the double will also get the roll for Denmark. They could sit three in a row. Don't think they're throwing too much weight at this. They're taking quite a lot of ice. Nice control to make sure that the shooter sticks around. Not according to plan. And I think the worst part was maybe not keeping the shooter around. What's Russia going to do now?
Draw?
I would think so. I don't think they're shot, but if they can get a shot stone in front of the T-line here, it's going to look very good.
Yeah, I wonder if Denmark would ever attempt a yellow-yellow combo. Take this shot first. John, one big guy, but he's shown some real nice touch in this game. making some really nice draws.
Yeah, and he can, by himself, he can really make a difference with the sweeping, too. Did he just tap it enough to sit two? I think he did.
Comes all deep, though, so we'll allow Denmark to come after with freeze of their own.
Really important freeze. Not a lot of room for error for Oliver. Didn't quite manage to keep the line where they wanted. Should be possible for Piotr to move this.
Сверху лучшим оставить можно?
Да, можно.
Чуть больше.
So I think Denmark's just going to come down here and tap the shot stone, a bit of foot back, and try and sit in the pocket of everything. Could be really hard for Russia to get it out. We're not really talking a pocket now, you know, talking sofa, parachute.
Makes it all the more comfortable. Calling good line. Just want to tap this out of the button.
Well,
oh, and we'll squeeze it in. A side freeze.
A side freeze.
I just touched this one.
Right. Wow, I think it's shot stone.
I think so too.
And I'm not sure.
Oh, look, you can see the pin right there.
Well, you put it this way, it's going to be very hard to measure.
Oh, there's still one more to go.
I've never seen a measure being called with two stones on the pin like that before. Do you even know what you do?
I think you. I think it's actually the umpire make a call, and if you can't decide which one's better, then I think it's a blank.
Yeah, it's cancelled out. Yeah.
Yeah. That would be quite hard for Russia, because if you blank in mixed doubles, you lose hammer.
Yeah. Well, I think Moiseva. Well, no. No, I think she might be throwing this one away. Looks like it. Yeah, I think they're throwing this one away.
So we're going to find out, Sander.
Well, for me it looks yellow. Well, we'll see what happens, if they call for a measure or not. So Moiseva is throwing this one away. And, yeah, we'll see what happens.
What do you say?
We need a measure.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, measuring. Good luck, says Oliver DuPont. Now, just try and listen in. It might look like he's just going to have a look here. Maybe wanting a second opinion. Yeah, no, this is a first for me. I always wondered what would happen. So he's pointing at yellow, that's what we were thinking, but all right. Team Russia could have asked for a second opinion from a different umpire, but we're going to trust that decision. That's what we were thinking anyway.
Yes. So that's an interesting steal.
Yeah, very much so.
And score is 5-3 to Denmark.
Yeah, so normally the umpire would bring out this big measurement tool and bring it and put it in the tiny little hole in the middle of the house, but there was just no room to do so. And just needed an eye measure. So, 5-3 for Denmark after five ends.
So, do you want to tell us what's going on in the other games?
I really want to.
I knew it.
Japan steals three in the fifth to make it a 9-1 game over Slovakia. Very young team. The male player on that team is 15 years old. So it's a great experience for them. Next to them, we'll have... Well, next to Arshit, Turkey is playing USA. So far, 4-1 lead for Corey Dropkin and Sarah Anderson over Turkey. Australia has been clawing back at Switzerland after giving up the maximum of 6 in the first end. They took 2, stole 1, forced, and has taken 2 again. So now it's only 7-5 for Switzerland.
I can see an extra end coming.
Yeah, another upset on the cards, perhaps. While France just picked up a single in the fifth, the Czech Republic will lead that game 6-2 after five ends. And as we see Moiseva coming down here.
Really trying to keep the line, but will overcurl.
And there's a bit of a pocket for Denmark to freeze onto.
Yep.
pretty nice.
Yeah, that's good.
Nestles in the pocket, and Moiseva is called to appeal on the center guard. Or are they changing their mind?
I think that my Russian isn't that good, Sander, but I think they're changing their mind.
Yeah, I think they're going to have to move these yellows around a little bit. Just come to the face of the stone just played by Oliver with the back ring weight to free up the back yellow. Back yellow. Well, it doesn't quite do that. Really wanted to catch out of here on the inside to move the second best yellow and free up the best yellow stone. He ends up punching his own red all back, but still not too bad. Sits on top of the yellows.
Det var mit draw shot her, ikke?
Ja.
Ja, der.
Yeah, Denmark gonna come in on the other side. Really freeze the red ones away. Quite early for line. Looks like they're gonna have some room, but the question is, will they have enough speed? I don't think so. Or what do you think of that?
Yeah, I don't think that's too bad. Corner frozen. Denmark still lying one.
Можно, но если они откроют, придется какой-то рейс бить. Хотя у нас тогда будет и здесь, а так и здесь, да?
Да.
Хороший вариант. Давай.
So talking about maybe slashing their own red, but electing the freeze instead. This is definitely a typical mixed double end. Everything in the forefoot, pretty much.
Если что, потом через этот бить.
Quite an important freeze here for Dron. Don't want to allow Denmark to just close everything off. It's starting to look like that yellow shot stone is going to be trouble moving.
Yeah, well, that's what sort of mentioned earlier there, where John didn't move the back yellow, and it might be prove hard to move the shot stone, but still that slash stone on the left-hand side.
Yeah. I think... Denmark's going to hit this red now, get rid of the back one, and then maybe protect the yellow shot stone from going by pushing the middle red down there and sit on top of everything.
Yep.
Pretty good shot. I think that's what they were playing for.
Yeah, I think the yellow shot stone might still go, but they've left themselves a usable stone in front.
Oliver Dupont saying, "I'm starting to get old." Getting all exhausted from the sweeping.
I guess that will feel good for his older sister to hear.
He's only 25, Oliver.
Comparing to you, Sander, do you feel old?
Well, I'm born the same year as him, so I think everyone feels all older all the time.
And that makes sense.
But if you're 25 and telling a 48-year-old you're feeling old, yeah, you might not get the best response.
Denise isn't 48, though, Sweep. Just for the record.
All right. Whoa. Big wait from...
See if he can make the yellow fly. Yes, but... Again, did they really think this through?
I'm not sure if they had to play that much weight. Obviously, with that weight, they're always going to spin that red zone on the left out of the forfeit. But they have left themselves short on the right hand side, but that's going
to Denise just needs to make contact with the yellow one, and they're going to set three. Oh, really, really wide, this one. Need to dig in.
Well.
Oh, and the second prize, I think. But...
Yeah, I wonder if that's not too bad, actually.
It'll be hard for Russia to score two. I mean, they can make that yellow go for one, but that's only to score one.
Yeah, I think that's really the only option here. It's not the first time we've seen Denise overthrow her intern. She did the flash one in the very first end, leaving Russia with a split for three. That didn't come off. They only scored the one. And I think Team Russia has decided on playing this outturn tap. So we're just going to hit the yellow next to John's broom here, and the one behind it, the shot stone, will go, leaving Russia sitting shot with the one already in the forefoot. Pretty makeable shot for Moiseeva.
Sweep!
And I think we're seeing red lights here for Victoria early Christmas, meaning she has not been able to release the stone before the hog line, and a little sensor in the eye in the hog technology in the rock has detected that, and stone starts lighting red, so it's a violation of the hog line rule. And she'll stop the stone on her own. And it's actually going to be a steal, a one for Denmark. So it's the first hog line violation we've seen so far on the broadcast. Nothing that really happens a lot, even in regular curling or mixed doubles.
No, it's fairly rare. And obviously it's rare because you have to take your stone off if you slide past the hog line, and you normally don't want to do that. But quite a nice break for Denmark. They will move up to a 6-3 lead.
Yeah, stolen twice in a row now. three ends where Russia hasn't been able to score. And now we're entering the seventh end, so we're in the odd ends. Yeah. Not the best end to score for Russia, but when you're three down, you really need to get a get some points on the board.
Next no matter team, what end it is.
Yeah, next team to score has to be Russia, or we're going to have big problems turning this game around. They would like to score three or more. Try and tie the game up and maybe steal in the eighth end.
Yeah, Denmark may be a bit overly excited here. They will ship off and roll. So just a bit too much weight on that one.
You'll see Moiseva's numbers 45% after six ends. It's a lot less than where she wants to be. We've said anything above 70 is fairly solid in mixed doubles play. 45, of course, some way off of that.
She will play a nice one here. That's a really perfect weight.
Result for Denmark?
No, just giving more backing to Russia and not controlling the front of the rings at all.
Ну, в идеале вот так. Это я могу тоже.
Давай.
So timeout called. Сергей Беланов will give them his point of view.
Да, гард снимать уже нет, потому что у нас стоит лучше.
Это такой как бы. Самый задорный.
Да.
Сервить этот камень не очень хочется, потому что он хороший.
Да, да. Но единственное, с этой стороны мы хорошо, ну, как бы довольно хорошо знаем, как тейп сделать. А здесь вот этот вот.
Все мы знаем, только что изгладить.
Да.
Если чуть шире, понимаешь, тоже он не бесполезный получится. Мы сюда куда-нибудь.
Да, оставим здесь просто, этот потом можно будет убирать. Ну, в принципе, мне только два варианта и нравятся. Фриз мне не нравится. Что если он даже если он получится вот такой, то это вообще вот этот потом не достать. Ну и через него
да,
не сыграть.
Фриз. Он только идеальный, хороший. Да и то может там как бы.
Да.
Не, но он хороший, идеальный.
Ну, вообще, мне нравится, конечно, пробовать это доставать. Наверное, уже надо рисковать.
Да, это не такой уж риск.
Ну, в принципе, да, если даже сюда привозим.
Два варианта. Тэп красного, тэп
с
желтого.
Справа. Или слева. Убираем чуть желтый, на наш навешиваем. Лукошка все равно дальняя получается. То есть он, получается, стоит в четырех футах, еще
нет,
есть.
Нет, если ты делаешь тэп желтого сюда, у тебя...
Мы и хотим вот, над этим вот здесь желтым оставить.
Да. А, от него от ролика?
Да, да.
Вот так, да.
О, да, 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 хорошо.
Вот а нам тоже больше нравится.
Стороны, вот, она валит очень
близко. Либо вот этот тэп. Да, да. Просто не хочется вот этот камень трогать сильно. Ну, потому что он хорошо стоит.
Он лучше, да, сейчас?
Он лучше.
Да,
да. Давай. Давай,
да, да, даже давайте. Если мы ошибаемся, оставляем просто вот этот, вот так, то мы потом этот сможем все равно достать.
Вес.
Да.
Сделать желтый хуже красного.
Да, 6, 8.
Я тебе с 10 ставил.
С 10?
Я думаю, 8.
8?
Или вот так нормально?
Вот так.
And that some that's some solid mixed doubles numbers, 88% for Piotr Drón. He has been very good this game.
Конец дома.
Yeah, so almost a little surprised to see Russia trailing by three, but again, it's Moiseva struggling out there at 45% after six ends.
Yeah, but remember, she threw one away, and that was a steal. And then she hogged one, and it was a steal.
Oh, I'd say the hog line violation is a personal error.
Yes, of course. And even the young ones are learning to cheer for curling early here in Sochi.
Yeah.
So now it's time for Denmark to get rid of the guard. They have 3 stones left and a 3-point lead. And they are facing 3 red counters, so really need to clean this up. If they give two to Denmark in this end, they're still going to be fine. Well, fine, they're still going to be in a very good position for the last end. So just need to make sure you don't give Russia any more than 2 points.
I wonder if they're actually trying to run back here, though.
I think just they are.
Throw it super hard, and you know, if you're not able to run it back into the stones, at least you peel the guard, and that's what he's done. Has certainly the tolerance. Sometimes you'll see teams, well, we're peeling the guard, we might as well try to run, throw it really, really hard. It's a bit less accurate, but no risk in playing it that way. So no guards. Three Russian stones in the forfeit.
А если мы привезем, и он пробьет, у нас будет плюс 2, и нам ничего не надо будет выковыривать. Знаю, мне кажется, нужно сюда привезти, пусть, ну серьезно, пусть бьет. Вот, да, вот если вот он так встанет, она уберет только один, этот вот сюда пойдет.
Он
и этот
кидает.
Не уйдет.
Еще он кидает.
Но... А, и у нас еще один камень?
Да, у меня второй камень, что ты сказал.
Да, окей.
Are they putting the guard back up, or what's the call?
Well, my Russian is a bit limited, so couldn't quite tell you, but it's quite possible. Or maybe they're trying to come into the forefoot and set up some awkward angles for Danes. Looks like a guard.
Altså hvis vi går efter fuldbrysten, falder det for meget, ikke?
Ja.
Ligger den så dårligt, så ligger den stadig godt, ikke? Mm. Den her over, så kan han ikke pile den ud den vej.
Nej.
I hvert fald.
Det er bare svært at lave en...
Men det er jo bare T-line, ikke? Altså hvis den bare klikker. Ja. Vi skal ikke skubbe den længere.
Det er jo svært at lave en god dobbelt lige nu.
Ja, for os?
Ja.
Helt klart, fordi du har kun den der 1'eren i 6'eren, ikke?
Ja.
Og der er ikke engang 10 for, at den ikke jammer.
Jeg har ikke set så meget af den.
Nej, præcis.
So Oliver Dupont maybe not feeling that there's any gimme doubles or triples. So instead of blasting away here, it's gonna try and freeze in between the two reds and the forefoot.
Yeah.
Important shot, this one. Really cannot afford a miss here because it will give Russia a chance of scoring a bundle, putting a lot of pressure on Denise.
Oh, I'd say that's pretty good.
See, that's very good.
I'm not quite sure how they're going to be able to remove that yellow.
No, but I think they can sit too after this.
Yeah, I think they're going to play a nose hit here. And you'll see the back yellow there fly. Yellow might squeeze through the forefoot jam on the one on the back to the right, but might be able to remove that later on. So you might see a lot of red stones in the house. A bit of a scare into the Denise. Denmark only having one stone left to go. Catches this one a bit high and shoots it through the hole. Not quite sure if that was a plan, but it wasn't too bad of a result.
No, but if Denise can freeze this, they will achieve their goal, which is keeping Russia to a score of two in the seventh end.
If she peels it off, rolls herself off, so she'll get the one. So it's two.
She'll get the
two. She'll
get the two. We'll be sure that it comes down.
But it should be ice. It should not be here and lie.
No, no, no. It
should be there. Are we here?
Yeah.
Be pretty accurate with this one.
God retning. Det skal en tee line.
Ja. Vi er lidt tunge herude.
So they're happy with line, but they need this all the way down to the T line. And it seems like she's got some great weight, but it will overcurl. And I think with the angles, there will be a shot for three.
Question is there... Well, they were hoping not to overcurl it. This way, they actually overcurl it even more than they were thinking. So making this shot a little harder. Moiseva will just play the tap though, so this time nice weight control call. No need to overthrow this one. Very easy to roll off with the shooter. But again, lots of rotation. We'll make this a little harder for Moiseva, and she will roll off, but leaving two counters for Team Russia. Score of two, but Denmark will still have the lead. 1 point up on Denmark, sorry, on Russia. So 1 point lead. And the last one advantage, generally. That'd be a very, very big advantage in regular curling, but in mixed doubles, I'd say anything can happen. It's very, very easy to steal.
Yeah, it's a steal-friendly type of game. It's still advantage having the last stone. So one up with hammer is, well, it's definitely better than being one down. But with this setup, center guard, one back of the T-line, it's quite good for the team looking to steal. So our recommendation is that you try and get the center guard off as soon as possible, because it's maybe the most important weapon for the team that's trying to steal.
Would you ever consider throwing the tech shot on the very first one?
I definitely would. Would you?
See where this one ends up first. This is a key shot, of course. This first freeze keeps the line nicely. Just going to tap that 1.5 foot back. This is an excellent shot by Victoria Moiseva.
Alin! Nej, bare derind.
Ja. Ja. Bare ude, hvor jeg plejer.
Oh. Synes du ikke, vi skal, synes du ikke, vi skal trykke den lidt?
Going all back and forth
here, Oliver. De vil bare blive ved med legater, hvis det er.
Ja, 10.
Ja, 9 er fint, tror jeg.
Ja. Yeah, so first thinking, well, we should tap it, and he called the freeze, then changing his mind again, thinking, well, you really need to move it, and I think you agree on that call, Sarah.
I do, and he also said that we can play it tight if you wreck on the garden, that's fine, and I agree.
This one waiting for line. So, with them waiting for a line that long, I'm not going to really tap it too far. You wanted to maybe tap the red one onto the yellow, try and free up the red a little bit, but still frozen on to that back yellow.
Да, по линии можно немножко подержать.
Сначала 8.
Свист! Давай, 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 давай!
Сначала!
And this could be a costly mistake.
Well, the Erlang shot though.
Yeah, but the chance of getting another one in there versus allowing Denmark to remove two stones with one.
Yeah, I think you might see Denmark rip the guards here.
Yeah, also sådan der, ikke? Hørte du det? Okay. Samme i som jeg plejer at få på dem der. Ja.
Guards. Big weight from Oliver Dupont. Over curls a fraction. Doesn't get the second red, so off the hook there, Peter Drawn.
Yeah, his Oliver's first instinct was to play it the other way. Denise changed his mind and he needed to hit it a bit thinner. You run out of stones quick in mixed doubles. Three to go for Denmark. They need to make sure that they score. Or what they need to make sure is that Russia doesn't score.
One pulls up short too, or were they guarding all along?
They might have been guarding all along, but they would need more separation between the guards if it was to be a really good one. It's certainly another double attempt on its way.
Well, the shot stone for Russia is really well nestled in there. It's going to take more than one rock for Denmark to remove it. And, although he doesn't get both guards off here. Oliver does open it up enough.
Thank you.
So guarding again, and this time if he makes this, Denmark's definitely going to need to run it back into the stones in the house. Going to need some movement on the pile in the forefoot. He can probably see some of the yellow.
Well, remember that Denmark, they're up by one here. So giving up a steal one, they're still in it.
True.
I think I think you just want to blast it here. Try and open up the forefoot. So locked in there, that Russian shot stone.
So hope that last minute doubt from the skipper doesn't get into Oliver's head. He needs to make this run back.
He's got that big extension. Which makes it all harder to be accurate, and he's just going to run it past all the stones on the forefoot.
Yeah, I think we might be looking at an extra end.
Well,
unless Denise can pull out something amazing.
And you know, the.
Is there an in off?
Yeah, the shooter stayed in play on the wide wing there. Denise thinking was just about to remove it, but. They never touched the board, so they kept it in play. Looking at it, though, it's a pretty tough angle to come off it to get to the red.
But well, they won't have anything to lose by playing it, so could give it a go.
We'll see. First, we'll see where Moiseva's last stone ends up. Wants to cover most of the top yellow here. And she will. Now, either you run that red onto the yellow and onto the shot zone, try and squeeze it out with lots of power. But I guess there is a slight danger you might give up to that way. Play the in off is, as you said, risk-free.
But it's, but
it's very thin.
It's very hard.
It's going to be very accurate.
We need to have a hotline umpire, because I think we're going besides the magnetic line.
Okay.
I think we're going besides the magnetic line, so a hotline, yeah.
That's a good call or good observation by Oliver Dupont. Certainly, he's probably been there before. There is a magnetic strip, which is in the ice, and it only reaches so far. It's about 4 feet, I think, 5 feet. And since they're coming out so wide, Oliver is worried that the stone's going to actually run past the side of the magnetic strip, not activating the technology on the rock. Here you see it, just it's painted white, but you'll just see it. A few spots on it, and it'll end about there. So I'm not sure if she'll be outside it, but Oliver just making sure, putting an umpire on the hog line to watch the stone. We'll see if the green lights turn on. Yeah, green lights as usual. So didn't come beside it. Well, what's going to happen to the shot? Well, it was very close.
She's it's so well played.
That is a really good attempt by Denise. Just couldn't move it enough.
Yeah, hats off for that shot. It was really well played and so close. Look at this. But still, it's one steal for Russia, and we're going to see our first extra end.
We will. Yeah, she had to catch that just a hair thinner, you know, the rotation on her rock. Was working against her there. It could have been shot of the week.
It definitely could have been.
But just not enough, and as you said, first extra end of the week on our broadcast. And if I'm not mistaken, that's going to be the only game still ongoing out there in the Ice Cube Curling Center today, because we have four finals. We saw Japan beat Slovakia 12 shots to one. The Czech Republic picked up a win against France, 7-3. USA has run Turkey out of stones, beating them 6-2. And even though Australia put up a really good fight against Switzerland after conceding 6 in the first end, they have lost that game 6-8. But if you take away the first 6-ender, Australia won 6-2, so they didn't really claw back, but not enough. All right, extra end, end 9. Victoria Moiseva played a really solid freeze in the 8th end to set up for the steal this time.
Looks like she's going to overcurl this a little bit now, so they're off the sweeping, trying to make sure that it sits in front of the tee line, but it doesn't. And now I would also like to see the take on the guard. I'm not sure another one on the tee line here is really going to help Denmark.
Or at least move the red stone on the forefoot, maybe.
Yeah. Six.
They're playing the straight freeze. Just one hanging out there. Can't be heavy, can't create a pocket,
no.
But I think they will. Slips in behind a tee.
Yeah, that that's not the right error. Sorry, Sander.
Yeah, no. just not the result they were looking for. There's a whole lot of other things they could have done. Now we'll see if Peter John can make the setup shot. Very often when you need to steal, you just need to make one good shot. Stuck guarding it for your life, just like we saw in the 8th end. Drone also hanging out there a little bit, but starting to curl here in the end.
This is going to be good.
Oh, perfect job by Peter Drone. He's made some pistols today, and there's another peach by the 9.5-foot tall Russian.
So DuPont is tapping this. Oh. Really playing with fire.
Yes. Oh, den er også lidt
vred. Oh, Oliver saying this one's a bit pacey, and he's already stopping.
Oh, it really needs to dig in and curl.
That is not what they were looking for.
No big trouble for Denmark in the extra end. They do have hammer, but it's really in favor of Russia right now.
Линия супер.
Приз.
Возьмем. Только вес.
Крис.
Только вес. Оттуда. Вау. Больше веса.
Крис.
Вау, линий очень много.
Давай ниже.
Свип. Вау, точно есть. Свип. 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 Убирай, 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 убирай.
So that didn't really make a much of a difference because it was a bit long. And I think someone is a little bit nervous.
He was covering his whole face with his hands earlier.
Altså om ikke andet får vi fjernet bagstoppen. Hvis den bare tager den gule, så tager den også den røde, ikke?
Ja.
Så må vi finde på noget på den sidste.
Ja.
Er det på?
Perhaps apparent. Not quite sure.
Herude.
Hva? Ja, det ser fint ud der. Jeg skal ramme den forholdsvis tynd.
Gonna try and hit this...
Jeg skal ramme den forholdsvis tynd, ikke?
Jo.
Side frozen red on the side. It could perhaps get both moving here. At least get rid of the backing. Get some space in the forefoot. It's really important for them, for Denmark. 76% is quite solid for Oliver Dupont.
What's going to happen here? Oh. There we go.
A lot could happen there.
The reds go flying, opens up the forefoot. That's an excellent shot by Oliver Dupont.
Yeah, there's really only one troubling them now, and it's a good thing for Russia that yellow stone managed to stick around just back of the button. Freeze is still available.
Kind of ironic that's your own stone creating the most problems for you, but it's all very often the case, especially in mixed doubles curling. And now Peter Drawn going to play the freeze. He's done it so many times in this game.
But
now really needing a good one. Extra end and all. Good comeback by the Russians, scoring two in the seventh, stole one in the eighth. Trying to steal the game away from Denmark here. This one just going to bounce the L a little bit. Oliver's first call is an off double. Timeout call by Dupont. Just for time, he says. He got 58 seconds left on the clock, so not too much time to think, but with the timeout they'll have a few extra minutes. Try and listen in.
Jeg tænker dublen er større chance for at sidde lige skabet, ikke? Hvis vi spiller dublen, ikke? Sidder den der.
Hvis den, jeg er mere bange for, hvis den ikke er der, den dobbelt. Hvis den dobbelt den ikke er der.
Så drager hun en lige ind på snuden.
Drager hun ind hen her, og hvad gør vi så har vi E, altså.
Så skal vi bare være kolde og spille den dernede. Er det rigtigt skud? Så. Hvor kommer den der?
Ja. Altså, jeg synes, det godt, den er mega god, hvis den er der. Hvis den ikke er der, det er det. Så efter vi sådan noget rigtig møg til os selv bagefter.
Lad os nu sige, at den er der, ikke? Så sidder okay. Så sidder vi der. Hvis der vi får den rigtigt, ikke?
Ja.
Selvom hun drager dig ned, så har du klatten bagefter.
Ja.
Den is, vi har spillet 100 gange. Hvis vi spiller den her nu, så skubber den her ned.
Men så har hun jo ikke skudt.
Altså, hvis vi... Hvad siger du? Dublin eller den der sidste? Den tabet? Sidste. Okay.
Hvis så har hun ikke skudt.
Nej, det er også det, vi står og taler om. Det eneste er, altså, jeg tror bare, at dublin... Altså, det er bare... Ja, det eneste er, hvis jeg spiller den anden, og den laver den der, ikke også? Ja. Og bare sætter den lige der, så kommer der en til. Det eneste er bare, hvis...
Vi giver hende et sværere skud på
den
der.
Den her?
Ja.
Så er den, vi spiller. Godt, så er den, vi spiller. 10 line.
Nej, du skal vælge
8. Så, 9.
Ja, du skal spille den fart, du lige spillede før.
Ja, men så det var bare alt for hurtigt, den kører jo alt for bredt.
Ja. Ja, spil den 9.
Ja, okay.
So, a lot of discussion there by the Danes. There's really two options they were discussing the whole time. It was either the in-off double, which was Dupont's, Oliver's first call, but you just made it clear that if that shot wasn't going to be made, they'd be in big trouble. So
whoa.
You're going to play the tap on the red stone.
Yeah,
no, it should be pretty close to this one. Turn the curl. Now Denise calling off her brother. And that's a superb shot. Enough for Denmark to lie one even.
Yeah, that's absolutely perfect. Russia needs to move this. And I guess they can, but that should leave some sort of nose hit for Denise with her last.
Yeah, what they're going to have to try and do is push the red one, sorry, the yellow one out of the forefoot and then try and sit in front with their with the shooter. So catch the yellow one as thick as possible without jamming. About two thirds. Try and sit there, maybe even force Denise to play the in-turn draw or the double. Pressure shot here in the Olympic arena with all eyes on one person, especially without the sweepers, you feel a bit alone.
Yeah, of course, and when it's Russia playing, all the fans have stuck around.
Yes, yes!
Nothing for line so far. Is it going to curl enough?
It's going to be enough for Russia to sit shot, that's for sure, even sitting two.
And we are going to see a draw to the button for the win.
Yeah, not a bad attempt there by Moiseva. Yeah, 30 seconds left on the clock, says Oliver. So either play the cool draw to the button or play the same type of shot that Oliver just played, you know, the backline weight and tap the red. And I think that's what they're going for. 10 seconds left here. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. There she crosses the tee line. 2 seconds left on the clock. High pressure shot to win the game here in the extra end.
Hope that didn't mess with her preparations or release, because this is wide. She will stop right there, and what's going to happen now?
She will roll too far.
Heartbreaking for Denmark. They were in a hurry, maybe a bit sloppy with their last, and Russia is going to remain undefeated. 3 straight wins. Denmark gets their first loss in the extra end, and what a comeback for Russia. Just stole the 8th end, stole the 9th end, and they will get away with a win. So high fives there, and if you stay tuned, you're going to get some highlights from this very exciting matchup between Russia and Denmark. We're also going to have an interview with the Russian team. And of course, you can watch us again tomorrow at 12:30 when we will bring you the game between Spain and Canada. First end of the game between Russia and Denmark. It was Victoria Moiseva with an opportunity to score as many as three with a split. She will come up a bit short and get only the single, but Russia with the early lead, 1-0. And in the second end, stones were spread wide. And in the end, it was Denise Dupont with an open takeout for three. So they will have a 3-1 lead after two. And it was the same in the third end. Wide open hit for a multiple score, and Victoria Moiseva managed to stick around with her shooter to score two and tie the game after three. Just before that half-time break, it was once again Denmark and Denise Dupont with hammer. Doesn't manage to hit the red one thin enough, but she will score a one. And in the second half of the game, we saw Denise play this freeze that ended up on the side of the red shot stone. Russia threw theirs away, and after the umpire having he had the second look, there was no way to get a measuring stick in there. It was a steal of one for Denmark, so they move up to 5-3. In the sixth end, Denise's final stone was to push this yellow one in, and after a hogline violation from Russia, that resulted in yet another steal. Seventh end, Moiseva pushes this yellow one out of the forefoot for a score of two to close the game up, 6-5 before the final and eighth end, where Denmark had hammer and Denise had a very, very difficult in-off, and she is so close to making it, but it is a steal for Russia. Game is tied after eight ends, and there will be an extra where it was once again Denmark and Denise Dupont with the final stone. But she was very short on time, a bit stressed, gave it a little bit too much. She will roll too far. And after a very exciting game, it's Russia that picks up the win. They will remain undefeated now at three wins. And we are going to bring you an interview with the Russian team coming right up.
Another win for Russia today. How do you feel about the game?
Oh, we're really happy that we can get this this win, because we were really down in this game, and then it was a comeback.
We saw Denise Dupont only have 2 seconds left on the clock when she played her last shot. Do you think that affected her throw?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Now, you played a couple of games here to qualify. Here in the Ice Cube Center, do you think that's an advantage for you to play in, on, you know, in your home rink?
Yeah, I think it's an advantage, because all the spectators are cheering for us, and it really helps, and especially the arena. Yes.
Now, is it a dream for you to win gold in Russia in front of the Russian crowd?
Yeah, sure, of course it is. Yes.
Thank you very much.
Теперь мы продолжим по-русски. Продолжим по-русски. С победой вас, Петр, Виктория. Как сложно было вернуться в игру после вот такой не очень хорошей серии? Вот это вот решение с камнем, когда вы отказались играть, и все-таки судьи присудили камень соперникам.
Конечно, вернуться в такую игру, тем более после такого моменты, вот как в пятом энде, что судя камень нельзя было померить, нам было тяжело вернуться, но я верил, что мы сможем это сделать. В принципе, так и получилось в итоге.
Очень хорошо. Ну и, наверное, отметим еще ваши действия в восьмом и девятых эндах, когда, собственно, приходилось воровать, и это удалось. Ну и, конечно, наверное, хорошее начало было.
Ну, мы очень собрались, конечно, в конце, и мы уже понимали, что отступать некуда. Остался всего один энд, в котором надо было украсть, и потом еще один.
Хорошо, спасибо. Еще раз с победой.